Good afternoon, everyone. Today we will discuss about the topic parallel lines and transversal. So how shall we define parallel lines? Here we have drawn two lines represented by M and N. If the distance between these two lines are same everywhere, suppose if you take any point on M and draw perpendicular to the other line N, this is also perpendicular, this is also perpendicular, and suppose this height is H, and take another point and draw perpendicular on both the lines, and if this length is also H, that means the distance between any two lines are same everywhere, then these two lines are called parallel lines. So how shall we define? If the distance between any two lines is same everywhere, are called parallel lines. So these two are called parallel lines because the distance between them are equal to h everywhere. Here it is h, here it is h. If you draw the third one, it is also equal to h, but it should be perpendicular on both the side. This will be also equal to h. So this is the concept of parallel lines. Here two or more lines are satisfying this condition, then they are parallel. Suppose if you draw the third line like that and distance between these two perpendicular are also same, may not be equal to h. It is not necessary that distance between these two is equal to h, then distance between these two equal to h. That may be different from h. Suppose this is k, small k. Still, the distance between these two parallel lines are same everywhere. Therefore, these two are parallel. And if these two, are, m is parallel to n, n is parallel to, suppose p, then all three lines are parallel. And represent, they are represented by m is parallel to, n is parallel to p. Now, two or more lines, if here we have shown the case of two parallel lines, if two or more lines which are parallel, third line can be taken, fourth line can be taken. So at least two lines should be there which are parallel. So two or more parallel lines, if it is, they are cut by a third line, here two lines P and Q are cut by a third line represented by small r, then this third line is called the transversal. So this line is called transversal. This is true for two or any number of more lines. It can be third, can be fourth, and all the four lines are cut by a single line, then this one is called the transversal for all those lines. It is not necessary that lines should be parallel. They may not be parallel. If these two lines are drawn, which are not parallel, still the third line will be the transversal. This is also transversal for these two lines. But mathematically, there is no significance of such lines. If they are not parallel, results are cannot be derived, or it is not so useful. Therefore, we used to take or consider the parallel lines. So here, two lines are taken which are parallel, and they are cut by another line. Third line represented by small r is called the transversal. Now, angles are marked by 1, 2, 3, 4 to 8. So these number of angles, which are 8 in numbers, are form certain pair of angles. So let us discuss one by one. First, the pair of corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. These are all the concepts of pair of angles. So corresponding angles means two such angles whose looks are same. So here we can see that angle 1 is very much similar look as that of 3. So 1 and 3 are called corresponding angle. 8 and 6 are called corresponding angle. 7 and 5 are called corresponding angle. 2 and 4 are called corresponding angle. So how many pairs are there? 4 pairs are there. I am writing A, B, O, C, or 1, 2, 3, 4. First pair is 1 and 3, angle 1 and angle 3. Second pair, 2 and 4. Third pair, 6 and 8. And fourth pair, 7 and 5. So they are having the similar type of the look. See here, 6 and 8, for example. So this is forming an obtuse angle. See this line and this line. Two rays are forming an obtuse angle. 8 is also same. So looks are same, and so they are corresponding angle. 1 is acute, 3 is also acute. They are, and if the lines are parallel, cut by a transversal, then such pair of angles are always equal. So 1 equal to 3, 2 equal to 4, see 2 equal to 4, 2 equal to 4, they are obtuse. 5 and 7 are acute, 5 and equal to 7, 6 equal to 8. So 4 pairs of corresponding angle. Then second, alternate interior angle. Interior angles. Number 1. Alternate interior means, see here, this on the two sides of the transversal, 2 and 6. It is also obtuse, this is also obtuse. 2 and 6, which are forming inside these two lines. So 2 and 6 are interior angles. One first pair, 3 and 7 are interior angles. So first two pairs are forming here, angle 2 and angle 6. Second pair, 3 and 7. Third, vertical angle or vertically opposite angles. Or in short, we used to write vertical angles. Vertical angle, whenever any two lines intersect each other, then the pair of vertically opposite angles are formed. So here this line and this transversal are intersecting at this point. So vertically opposite are 1 and 7, 2 and 8. So they are also equal, 3 and 5, 4 and 6. So these are four pairs of vertically opposite angle. So number 1 is, see the figure, 1 and 7, they are also equal, 1 equal to 7. These two are forming a pair of angles called vertically opposite angles, and vertically opposite angles are always equal. Whenever any two lines intersect at a particular point, then vertically opposite angles are always equal. So first pair is 1 and 7, second pair is 2 and 8. Third pair, 3 and 5. Fourth pair is 4 and 6. So these are called vertical angles or vertically opposite angle. Four pairs are formed. Now, one more important aspect or result is there, which is applicable in course of solving the problem. That is the interior angle on the same side of the transversal. So interior angles are means forming inside. So 2, 7, 3, 6, they are forming inside these two lines cut by the transversal. So these four are interior angles. Now we have just studied that 2 and 6, first pair 3 and 7, the second pair which are interior angles, these two are angles 2 and 3, they are forming on the same side of the transversal, and 6 and 7 are forming on the left side of the transversal. That means on the same side of the transversal. So these two angles are having a peculiar property that if these two lines are parallel, then sum of these two angles is equal to exactly 180 degree. So they are called sometimes allied angles. So 2 and 3, number 4 is allied or co-interior angle. First is angle 2 plus angle 3 equal to 180 degree. Second, 6 plus 7. Equal to 180 degree. So if P and Q, these two lines are parallel cut by a transversal small r, then the pair of angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary, known as co-interior angles or allied angles. So 2 plus 3 equal to 180 degree, 6 plus 7 equal to 180 degree. So these are few pair of angles which are very much required in course of solving the problems. Next, we will solve few problems related to these concepts. Number 5 you can also write alternate exterior angle, one is left out. So write number 5 as alternate exterior angle. Just now we have discussed about alternate interior angle, now alternate exterior angle. So here number first pair is alternate exterior is equal to 1 and 5. See, 1 is acute forming outside the two parallel lines, but they are having the same measurement, so they are equal also in the case of two parallel lines when it is cut by a transversal. So 1 and 5, this pair is called alternate exterior angle. Likewise 4 and 8, so these two are called alternate exterior angle. First pair is angle 1 and angle 5. Second pair 4 and 8. See, 4 is obtuse, 8 is also obtuse, 1 is acute, 5 is also acute. They are also equal, 1 equal to 5 and 4 equal to 8. 4 and 8. Second pair, pairwise 4 and 8, but in measurement they are equal. Now let us solve a problem which is very important problem. Problem is, when two lines I have already sent you this particular problem as well as the solution of this problem. I am just discussing about it. When two parallel lines are cut by a transversal, let us represent these two parallel lines by P and Q and cut by a transversal R. Then the bisector of the co-interior angles, that means bisector of the angles formed on the same side of the transversal, meet at a particular point and that angle is equal to 90 degree. So required to prove is, if you draw the bisector of this angle and this angle, they will meet at a particular point. So let us represent it by A, B, C. So we have to prove that, to prove here, angle ABC, ACB, angle ACB equal to 90 degree, where it is given that this angle equal to this angle, that means 1 equal to 2, it is already given, 3 equal to 4. Why? Because AC is the bisector of angle, this angle, as suppose this PAB, and BC is the bisector of angle ABQ. Therefore, if this is the angle bisector, so one, this line will divide the entire angle A into two equal parts. So 1 equal to 2, 3 equal to 4. So given is equal, given is angle 1 equal to angle 2 and angle 3 equal to angle 4. This is given. Required to prove is angle ACB is 90 degree. So proof is, just now we have discussed that the pair of co-interior angles is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, we can write here as angle P is the complete line, this point is suppose M and this point is say N. So M A B, angle M A B plus angle MAB, this angle, complete angle, and ABN, this complete angle, ABN equal to 180 degree. The reason is, what is the reason? We'll write co-interior angles, this angle MAB and ABN forming co-interior angles. So write it there, co-interior angles. This implies for MAB we can write 1 plus 2, and for AB, ABN, the complete angle 3 plus 4. Equal to 180 degree. This implies, now as 1 equal to 2 and 3 equal to 4, so we can write for these two, 1 and 2, we can write 2 angle 1 plus, for 3 and 4 we can write 2 angle 3 equal to 180 degree. This implies 2 is common, angle 1 plus angle 3 equal to 180 degrees. This implies 1 plus 3 equal to 90 degrees. So we have shown that 1 plus 3 equal to 90 degrees. Now see the triangle, in triangle ACB, in triangle ACB, angle ACB plus angle 1 plus angle 3 equal to 180 degrees. Because this is a triangle, so sum of interior angles of a triangle is equal to 180 degree. So these are three interior angles of that triangle ACB. Now for 1 plus 3, from here put equal to 90 degree. So angle ACB plus 90 equal to 180. This implies on transposition of this 90 degree towards the right hand side, angle ACB equal to 90 degree. So this is your proof of the particular problem.